Hello everyone, today we will see how to create a ribs in SOLIDWORKS and how to create a shells in SOLIDWORKS. Okay, so again let us start with a new part. Now this is a rib option, adds a thin walled support to the solid body. So now we will see how to create a ribs in SOLIDWORKS. Just I will add a material on this problem with this rectangle and then exit the workbench. So again I will use this extrude boss base command to add a material. Now again I will create one feature here. I will select a corner rectangle, select this corner and select this and then exit the sketch. Similarly, I will again add a material over here and then you can do it. Now again for rib, from rib from side it requires a open profile, that is open line profile it requires. So now we will create that profile here on the front plane. So on the front plane I will create that profile. So create a line and select this point and select this face and just escape this line, and its edge should be coincident to each other. So now our line is ready. Now go to the rib and select this profile. So now here this is the rib from side is added, and then click OK. Again to edit, go to the right click and edit feature. So you can maintain this thickness side. So both side you want the thickness, so then this 40 mm added to the both side. That is 20 mm on the left side and 20 mm on the right side it will be added. If you want to add only on the one side, then this thickness is added only on the one side. Again to another side you can add this on the another side. So you can create a rib on this side. Again here you can add a draft here. So I will provide a draft to this rib. So you can provide that draft also. So you can see that the draft is added. So you can see that on the draft is added to the rib. So if you modify this draft, you can see that changes here. So I will uncheck the draft. And then click OK. So in this way you can create a rib from side. Now we will see how to create a rib from top. We will again save this. Yes, I will save rib from side. Now I will delete this feature. I will delete this rib also. Just right click and delete this. Okay, so now I will edit this feature and add a thickness here. Sorry, add a pad here. Okay, now we will see first how to create a shell. So shell means it is removes the material from the solid body to create a thin walled feature. So just select the shell and select here the faces to remove. So just select the face to remove. This is the thickness. Provide a thickness you want to keep here. So just provide a thickness and then click OK. So the shell is created. Shell is to create a hollow objects. So if you again, if you do not select any face, so still there is a presence of, there is a shell is created. So you can see that from this section view. So with this section view you can check that shell. Okay, so again if you want to remove this face you want to remove, again this face you want to remove, then you can select a multiple faces to remove. Now I'll again edit this feature. I will delete this and delete this face. I will select this face and then click OK. So now we will create a rib from top. So I will just create one plane here. From this face I will make a offset. So let us say it is 100 mm. So we are taking this plane because it is easy to modify the rib height. So now I will sketch on this plane. I will sketch on this plane here. Again go to normal view. And now I will create another profile here. You can add a profile that is intersecting. Then I will exit this. And then from the feature just select rib option and select this sketch. I'll just reduce this and then create a rib. So though these sketches are not touches to this wall, the material gets added up to this wall. So in this way you can create a rib with rib from the top. Again if you want to modify this rib, you can just right click on it, then change the thickness and then click OK. So in this way you can create a rib from top. And then you can create a rib from side and rib from top. So I will save this rib from top and save. Just save this. Now we'll see how to create a fillet here. So again I will show you. So first option is a constant radius. Just select this edge and provide a radius and then just click on OK. So the radius is radius with a constant radius fillet is created. So again if you want, I will again delete this fillet. Now select another and now select the variable radius. Now again I will select this edges to fillet. Now at this point you can change this radius here. So you can add multiple points and then click OK. So again, so if you want to modify this radius, just select the variable radius parameter, select the first parameter, so let's say it is 60, V2 parameter and then this 40 mm. So now I will again show you that. from this you just select just add this radius here and then click on the status sign and then click OK. So now you can see that the fillet with the variable radius is created. Now I will just reduce that and then you can create a fillet radius with variable radius. Okay, so again there is an option that is a face fillet. Just select this face and then click OK. Sorry, so I will just select this face and select another face so just select the face 1 and face 2. The fillet is created at the edges of these two faces. Similarly, the another that is a full round fillet, so here you need to select. So now we will see that, go to fillet. So I will change this geometry first. I will just delete this. I will delete this. Now we will see that. Now go to fillet, select a full round fillet, select this face set 1, side face, just you need to select the center face and then select the another side face and then click OK. So in this way you can create a full round fillet. So in this way you can create a rib, you can create a shell and you can create a fillets in SOLIDWORKS. Please subscribe my channel and like my videos. If you have any queries, please comment below. I will definitely try to solve each of them. So thank you for watching.